Okay, in 1986, my wife and I decided to build this house. This is a log house.
A house Robert Tuttle and his wife built themselves.
The thing that I wanted whenever I was building the house was to design the house so it would have a big old fireplace with a large mantle, because I wanted a big old boat on the mantle. I wanted something like a Spanish galleon.
So after he built a house, he decided to build a boat.
And when I built the boat, I knew I'd never be able to put it on the mantle because the mantle is just not big enough. So I built a piece of furniture to put it on.
But then he discovered a passion for a different kind of boat.
This is the first shrimp boat I ever built.
He spotted the real Captain Phillips while on vacation at the coast.
So there's big old outriggers sticking up there, you know, and I thought, man, we got to stop and look at that.
He did, and actually met the crew that worked on the boat.
And I decided if I really wanted to learn about a shrimp boat, I need to go on a trip on one. And I talked them into letting me go for a week with them and work as a deckhand. I said we worked like dogs, ate like hogs, and smelled like shrimp, but boy, we had fun.
After that, he would go on to build many models of the boats seen along North Carolina's coast.
Here, everybody had one of these.
And all made out of wood.
What I was building was built to scale. Pretty authentically built the same way they build the real ones.
But building a model, in many ways, is even harder.
It's so tedious. The lumber is so small. My fingers don't get smaller when the lumber gets smaller.
And building one just can't be rushed.
Yeah, it takes a long time.
But the finished products are works of art.
Most people say, golly, that looks real. This boat has just got lines when you look at it. I look at some of the boats that I build, and I kind of wonder, how in the world did you really do that?
Robert Tuttle's boats capture the beauty, history, and culture of the Carolina coast.
The people that know how to build these boats, the people that know how to use these boats, are close to being gone.
But thanks to him, they'll never be forgotten. In Forsyth County, looking for Roy's folks, Chad Tucker, Fox 8 News.